Now to the story of a turbulent couple of years in the life of Castleford's Rangi Chase. The New Zealand-born England international halfback was Super League's man of steel in 2011, but struggled to back that up in a far from golden 2012. Chase is, of course, hoping that better times lie ahead as he looks to regain his status as one of the best players in the game. Everybody,
well, don't you know it's me now? 2011 was a good year for myself. Picking up Man of Steel was, it took a while for it to sink in because I didn't think I was going to get it because our team finished outside the eight. Obviously the players thought otherwise and you know, I was very humbled and it was a big moment for me, a proud moment and something I'll remember, you know, for the rest of my life and something I want to do again. We played a good attacking style, you know, suited my game. I get to touch the ball a lot, you know, probably three or four times a set. You know, I gradually improved as a player and I started to learn my role instead of just playing on instincts all the time. I was just so confident and, you know, fans and my teammates and it had a lot to do with that. You know, when the crowd was behind me, it was an awesome feeling. I'd never experienced that before, you know, and they loved me. Season as a team was pretty bad for me, as an individual wasn't too good as well. I found it hard to adapt to the structures and I wasn't fully 100% into it, and I just wasn't happy. You know, seen in my performances, you know, sometimes I just give up and didn't want to be there sometimes. You know, I get frustrated at myself and at my teammates and probably spit the dummy where I should have just been the bigger man and just got along with it. Off the field, I wasn't doing the right things. I got picked up a few injuries, got suspended a couple of times. I wasn't good at the time. There's a lot of stuff going around that unsettled me. But looking back, it's good because you know the things I was going through, I found it hard to cope. And obviously, now I know what I need to fix. And it was just a bit of a wake-up call. You know, I could lose what I've dreamed of doing, just like that. And you know, I can't be doing the things I was doing off the field and stuff like that, because if I keep doing it, you know, I'll have nothing. And it's made me grateful for where I am today. My first baby boy last year, he settled me down, you know. It's made it sink in how lucky I was and how lucky I am. I've got a kid, got a family, got a wife. It's made me realise what's more important. Well, it's signed, you know, not really related. But we grew up with each other, we're like brothers really. His mum and dad called me son, you know, they took me in when my grandparents passed away there. And they looked after me, you know, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for them, you know, and obviously for Will as well. You know, we're here, living the dream together, you know, we get to play professional together, which means a lot to us. You know, he's got a young family, I've got a young family. It's going to be something that we look back on when we get a bit older and, you know, we have a few stories to tell our kids.
Take me outside. Sit in the green garden.
From us this year, you can expect a lot of improvement, you know. A better team performance. We're all happy with the way we're going. Everyone's buying into it. There's a positive feeling around the club, around the town, you know, we've bought well. Everyone has a role to do. It's not just reliant on me all the time. And with the way we play, there's opportunities everywhere if we do it right, you know. For me, it's more about what I do, you know, off the field. Do the little things, because I know if I do the things, I'll play well. And, you know, I've got to be more of a leader, put more quality into my game, because I come up with a few errors last year, a few too many. I just got to cut them out. But hopefully, you know, I can get some form like I was showing in 2011. There's always speculation. I think the guys who speculate need a new job because they always get it wrong. A lot of it happened last year. 90% of it was rumours, you know. 90% of it was made up. And it gets the fans unsettled and I need them to be on our side. And sort of made it look like I wanted to leave when I didn't. I'm 100% settled here. Put my everything into cash, you know. And that's it. 100%. You know, my mind's focused on the job here.
Ian, you watched that with great interest. Mm. What was your reading of what you heard from your player there?
Well, words can be pretty cheap, and I can tell you, he's backed those words up with action. His pre-season's been outstanding, and he's been outstanding on and off the field, and he's been the person that I've really respected as a player. He's been a leader when we start our games. Like last week against Leeds, the two tries we scored, he had a major hand in it. But he's also had a major hand in some of our team meetings and major hand in the way a professional should go about his business. And, you know, I can only sit back and applaud Rangi for the way he's sort of sat back and looked at himself as a true professional.
Well, here is, I suppose, the best and worst of Rangi Chase from that Leeds game. And this try, not only go through the gap, but I love this, the no-look pass. It's NBA basketball stuff. That was brilliant.
Yeah, but you've got to remember, you know, he's so talented as a player that we all expect it all the time now.
Well, talk me through this. What happened here?
Yeah, look, you know, I've got to say before we go any further, he's our last line of defence. So don't worry about him coming in quick. If Hardacre's beaten to it and he's our last line, we took some stuff to the judiciary which doesn't totally explain this full situation. We had some photographs from the other side of the field and we had a couple other things there. So let's not premeditate Rangi on that. All I would like to say is...
These players reacted angrily, so they probably
Not at the time they didn't. They acted very angrily in the press conference after they lost the game, which I was a bit disappointed with. But, you know, I would like to say this, is that Rangi and any player, whether it's Earl or anyone, if you make contact with the head of someone, whether it's careless, reckless or something, the rules are in place that it's a penalty. And I think that's a good rule. But I think you've got to be prejudged a little bit on that. And if someone could sit down and we could show them all the stuff that we come up with, a little bit different. But we accept it, we get on with it. Last time he went, we pleaded guilty. But can I just say on Rangi again there is that Rangi's so talented, you've got to remember that what you want him to do, you want him to be the icing on the cake for us. And probably last year and that, he's probably been doing everything, and now we're getting him to be the icing, which is what he's good at.
Well, he remains one of the most watchable players in Super.